British Rederi are rushing to settle in European countries such as Spain, Portugal and France before the Brexit deadline, according to financial advisor, believing that such a move will become significantly more difficult in the future. One company that supports those moving to mainland Europe after they finish working revealed that the number of Malay inquiries to its website had doubled in a year, while actual business was up by 25%. It came as experts said it was extremely unlikely that any post-Brexit deal with European countries would allow Britain to continue to move overseas in the later year as easily they can do now. The golden age of British Rederi heading to the coast is probably over. Said John Springford, a migration expert who is director of research at the Center for European Reform, Pivotal Research that found that why young immigrants provide an economic boost in most OECD countries, people turn into a net drain on national finance somewhere between the age of 40 and 45. The thing about Rederi, they are expensive. There is no way Spain would allow a lot of Brits to retire there and use their health system unless young Spanish people could come and work in the UK, said Springfield. If we don't have free movement it is very unlikely we would have retirement right. Carlos Wagasiwa, of the University of Oxford Center of Migration, Policy and Society Compass, agreed that the UK could strike a bilateral arrangement with Spain, but said that might not be encouraged by the EU. In order for British people to continue retiring to Spain there would need to be something in return, likely to be around more flexibility for Spanish people working in Britain. He added, there were estimated to be almost 300,000 UK citizens living in Spain in 2016, with 40% 121,000 over 65. In France, the figure were 148,800 with earlier estimates suggesting about 19% are at retirement age. Over 65 as make up a third of UK expats in Malta, Cyprus and Portugal, while overall they account for 1 in 5 of the 890,000 Britons living in the EU, while Brexit negotiations are likely to secure a deal to protect the rights of those already living abroad. There is a big question mark over what opportunities there will be after the UK leave the EU. A Home Office spokesman made clear that no decision had been made, and that businesses and communities would be consulted on what a post-Brexit immigration system would look like. However, he did admit that there were currently no route through which new citizens were able to retire into the UK, nor any bilateral arrangement of the type suggested by Wagasiwa. As such, the only possibility for the current situation to continue would be an immigration system for Europe that was significantly looser than the one that exists for the rest of the world. Jason Potter, Business Development Director at Levin Frank, which provide financial and tax advice to British expats, said he believed a deal would be struck. He argued that European countries had benefited from Britain buying property and spending money in shops and restaurants, but he admitted there had been a certain interest from those racing to beat the Brexit deadline. The feeling we are getting from our clients is that it is better to be in the country before Brexit than looking to do this after. He said, Levin Frank, with specialized in financial advice for those retiring into Spain, Portugal or France, has seen a 20% to 25% increase in business. He said, meanwhile, it received 900 inquiries to its website in 2017, compared with 450 a year earlier with the Brexit brought a significant part of the reason, according to Potter. Although he was confident of an agreement, Potter considered that the process could become more difficult and be easy for those with sufficient capital to buy a home and not be a drain on the country welfare system. The main concern that people thinking about retiring to Europe have around 3 main issues: resident, healthcare and the UK state pension triple lock. He said, arguing that the biggest worry for retiree would be access to healthcare. Chris Berg, of the Spectrum IFA Group, who advises largely British expats living in Spain, said he had one client who had taken early retirement to beat the Brexit deadline. People who are looking to retire to Spain are bringing it forward and moving out now before Brexit. P PLC 20% of his clients already living abroad were looking into whether they could obtain Spanish or Irish passport. Campaigner representing expat admitted that they had also witnessed a certain the number attempting to beat the Brexit deadline. Roger Bodden, founder member of expat citizen rights in EU, which has almost 10,000 members, said he had seen as a number of additional Brit on the scene being property in France where he is based. If free movement go and the UK become a third country, then unless there is a deal the second general come into play and the second general can be saver. He said it is a big area of WT, to Wilson, chair of Bremen in Spain which is also part of the coalition fighting for expat rights. Said the conversation were focused on the uncertainty facing those already living on the continent. 4.5 million people do not know what their future will look like, so that is the priority. She said, then we can look at what happened in the future, but one thing we are certain about it is not going to look the same as now. On an anecdotal basis, people are coming out, people who have had a dream for many years to retire to Spain are keen to do so while they still can.